One weary traveller's decade on the road has finally come to an end. In 2013, Thor Pedersen made it his mission to journey the entire world without flying. It was an adventure he figured would take just 4 years. Well, it took a little bit longer than that. Thor's arrived in the Maldives, his 203rd and final country, where he's having some much-needed R&R. And here he is, Thor Pedersen. Hey, Thor, when I think Maldives, I think of blue water and white sand, so where the heck are you?
Yeah, you should be thinking that. That brings the tourists to Maldives and the economy flowing. But I'm on the waste disposal island, so all of those resorts, they create a lot of garbage that goes somewhere. There's a mountain not far from where I am, and I'm inside a container.
Sounds like paradise. Now that it's all behind you, mate, be honest, what were you running from?
Yes, what was I running from? It could have been my wife, it could have been, I don't know, nationalism rising in Denmark.
Can I just observe, Thor, you just said it could have been my wife and then couldn't think of another one for quite a while.
Yeah, true. It's probably my wife then.
And speaking of your wife, so she visited you 27 times throughout your decade on the road. That's an average of 2.7 times a year. Is that amount of contact the secret to a happy marriage? Or are you not happy?
It could be, you know. So we got engaged on top of Mount Kenya on our 10th visit. Then during the pandemic, we got married online so that I could bring her inside Hong Kong. She came to Australia when I was in Australia. Next time we saw each other, we're in Vanuatu, and we got properly married for the second time. And none of that has been processed officially. So we know that we're married in Utah, which has the online agency, and we're married in Hong Kong because they accepted it, and we're married in Vanuatu, and that's it so far.
Oh, what about that? You don't even know if you've got a wife.
Hey, so this was a decade, as you mentioned, but like it was 6 years longer than you expected. COVID, obviously, a big part of that, couldn't travel. After all that and everywhere you've been, what's the worst bit of this whole journey?
Oh, well, that's a really good question. I mean, I had some really rough times in Central Africa as a region, but at the same time, beautiful people, beautiful culture, really good food. The pandemic had me caught in Hong Kong for 2 years. So it was really, really rough trying to guess alongside with everyone else when it would end and when I would be able to move on. But there have been ups and downs. I'd say far more ups than downs throughout the last decade, for sure.
All right, what's the best bit then?
Getting to be on the project twice. I mean, that's a huge win. Wow.
That's what I call joining the conversation, the shipping container.
You know, if you show that sort of charm to your wife, Thor, you're going to go okay.
Yeah, I'll give it a go.
You might end up married in other countries as well. Hey, Thor, why did you do this?
Well, it was primarily because it had not been done before, and I thought I would be able to go out and make my claim on world history. And at the same time, I thought it would be a great adventure. I'd just meet tons and tons of people and have all these amazing experiences, learn a lot about the world, and all that came true. And then I've been trying to profile every country as positively as I could, just to sort of alter people's perception of the world a little bit. So that's sort of the how and why.
It sounds like you've done a great job for every country except the Maldives.
Well, Maldives is excellent. And this is the only country where I arrived and I was welcomed with flowers. Not even Australia did that. I got a beer cup in Australia when I came.
Hey, Thor. Working holiday's over. Enjoy the Maldives. Appreciate your time.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for having me on. And thanks for all the support.